Welcome back to Decode's Frappe Developer tutorial. In this video, we will initialize our first Frappe bench into our system. For initializing Frappe bench, we can run this command bench init then the bench name. So I am going to open my terminal. You can use the shortcut Ctrl Alt T. Then my terminal is ready. And now I am in my home directory. Before running this command, you should make sure that your internet connection is active. So let's run this command bench init and give a name for the bench. I'm giving the name demo frappe bench and press enter. And it will clone Frappe repository from GitHub. Now we can see the installation of Frappe is started. Okay, now we successfully initialize our Frappe bench and the bench name is demo Frappe bench. Let's clear this and I am going to open my home directory. Here we can see a directory which is demo Frappe bench directory. Let's open this and we can see some subdirectories and files inside this demo Frappe bench. First we can start with apps, and apps directory contains the installed applications inside this Frappe bench. So let's open this directory and we can see the Frappe application, and by default when we initialize the bench, the Frappe application is also fetched from GitHub repository and install that application into our Frappe bench, and this application itself acts as a Frappe framework. Let's open this. And we can see some configuration files and Frappe app inside this directory, and we will see it in later videos. Next we can see the config directory, and which contains the Redis and Nginx configuration files. Let's open this, and here we can see some Redis configuration files. Next directory is env, and which contains the Python virtual environment. Here we can see the Python 3.8. Let me go back to Frappe bench. Next directory is logs, and which contains the logs of every process inside this bench. Now we can see one bench log. When we do some more processes, we can see the logs inside this directory. Next important file is proc file, and which contains the list of processes that run in development. And last and important directory is sites, and inside this site we can see some files and directory, and we can see asset directory, and it contains the CSS and JavaScript assets. Another important file is common site configuration file, and this file contains the site configuration that is available in all sites. So this is the overview of Frappe bench. Let me close this. Now we can start our application by using a command which is bench start. So before that, you should make sure that you are in a bench directory, because the bench commands can only run inside the bench directory. So if you run a command outside the directory, it won't work. So let's move to my demo bench. Now I am in my demo bench, which is a demo Frappe bench. Let's ls, and we can see the directories and files inside this bench. And let me clear this. And for starting our application, we can run this command bench start, then press enter. It will start the server. Okay, now successfully built all the assets, and here we can see the link to the Frappe application. So let me open this link, and I am opening this link in my Firefox web browser, and we got an error, which is a 404 not found error. It is because we didn't install any site into our bench. So next we have to install a site for running this Frappe application. So let me close this, and my bench is up and running. I am going to open one more tab here, and now we are in demo Frappe bench. For creating a new site, you can run this command bench new site, then let's give a site name demo.com. And then press enter. And we have to enter the MySQL root password because this site will create the database for our application. So let's enter the password. The bench also create an administrator user, and we have to enter the password for login as administrator. So let's enter the password and re-enter one more time. And now we successfully created our Frappe site. So let's open my Frappe bench one more time. And I'm opening the sites, and here we can see the demo.com. This is our new site, and it will contain some directories and one file, and here we can see the site configuration.json file. Let me open this, and this file contains the configuration for this particular site, and this configuration is only applicable for this demo.com. Here we can see the database name and the database password, and we are using MariaDB database. So the DB type is MariaDB. By default, the site is in production mode, and for programming, we have to change this site from production mode to developer mode. So we will do it later. Let me close this, and you can see the public and private directory, which contains the private and public files of Frappe framework. And this is the overview of site directory. Let me close this. In this video, we see how to initialize a Frappe bench and how to create a site. So let's wind up this video and see you on the next video. Bye.